angry. So Jonah went out of the city and sat on the east side of the city, and there made him a booth and sat under it in the shadow till he might see what would become of the city. And Jehovah God prepared and made it to come up over Jonah, over his head, him from his grief. So Jonah was exceeding glad of the gourd. But God prepared a worm when the morning rose the next day, and it smote the gourd that it withered. And it came to pass when the sun did arise that God prepared a vehement east wind, and the sun beat upon the head of Jonah, that he fainted and wished in himself to die, and said, "It is better for me to die than to live." And God said to Jonah, "Doest thou well to be angry with the gourd?" And he said, "I am angry to death." Then said Jehovah, "Thou art on the gourd, for neither madest it grow, which came up in a night and perished in a night. And should I not spare Nineveh, that great city, wherein are more than 80,000 persons?" Cattle. Well, here we have the interesting passage dealing with this gourd. Well, first dealing with a booth that Jonah went out of the city, and if you remember, this all ties in to Jonah and his name, as the name Jonah is the word dove or pigeon in the Hebrew, and Jonah sent a second time to Nineveh. Nineveh would be a type of the world. Jonah, a picture of the Holy Spirit in that sense, as the Holy Spirit is sent a second time into the world. When did God send the Holy Spirit a second time into the world? In the year 1994. The Jubilee year, it was the second outpouring of the Holy Spirit. The first began in 33 AD on the day of Pentecost, and that prolonged Jubilee period lasted for 1,955 years until 1988. Then there was a terrible famine for 2,300 evening mornings. It was the period in between Jubilees, in which virtually no one was saved. And then on September 7th, 1994, the trumpet of the Jubilee sounds. God stretches forth his hand a second time to recover the remnant of his people. And so we can mark Jonah 3 and the first few verses where God tells Jonah and commands him to go to Nineveh, and it's a second time. We can mark the date 1994. And we saw that's why it's so interesting that God says, proclaim the preaching that I, or how did it go? In Jonah 3, verse 2, "Arise, go unto Nineveh, that great city, and preach unto it the preaching that I bid thee." And what preaching did God bid Jonah? "Yet 40 days, and Nineveh will be destroyed." And 40 days, we saw, can identify with 40 years. And so Jonah goes into the city a day's journey, then goes outside the city to the east part, and he builds a booth, and he waits. And he goes to the eastern side of the city because that's the direction of the kingdom of God, the direction Christ comes. And we also saw, since he went one day's journey into the city out of 40, that would leave 39, that after he would come back out and go out there to build that booth. And so we had that interesting numbers relationship between 39 and 40, just like we find from 1994 through the year 2033 AD, is 40 inclusive years, but 39 actual years. And he's also The first thing he does when he goes outside the city is he builds a booth. And when we looked up a booth in Leviticus chapter 23, God informed us, or he informs the reader of the Bible, that the reason that Israel was to observe the Feast of Booths or the Feast of Tabernacles was to commemorate Israel's coming out of Egypt and their dwelling in the wilderness for how long? 40 years. And all the while they were in the wilderness, throughout that entire 40-year period, they lived in a booth. And so there again, we have that connection with the number 40, in this case 40 years, and the booth. With Jonah, it's 40 days. But even with Israel's dwelling 40 years in the wilderness, it was related to 40 days. Because the spies searched out the land 40 days, and then after the evil report, they had to wander in the wilderness a year for each day. And so here is Jonah, again, in verse 5 of Jonah 4. So Jonah went out of the city and sat on the east side of the city, and there made him a booth and sat under it in the shadow till he might see what would be. Who remembers what the booth identifies with and spiritually represents? It identifies with the Word of God. Because of Isaiah chapter 4, Isaiah 4, and also Nehemiah 8, but we won't go to Nehemiah. In Isaiah 4, it says in verse 5, and Jehovah will create upon every dwelling place of Mount Zion and upon her assemblies a cloud and smoke by day and the shining of a flaming fire by night, for upon all the glory shall be a defense. And there shall be a tabernacle, and that's the word booth. There shall be a booth for a shadow in the daytime from the heat, and for a place of refuge, and for a covert from storm and from rain. And that's exactly why Jonah built the booth. That's what it says here. He went out of the city, sat on the east side, made him a booth, and sat under it in the shadow, so he might see what would become of the city. And the next thing we're reading about the sun beating down upon him. So Isaiah 4 is very much related to this booth that Jonah built. And then, strangely, because we're reading that Jonah built a booth, he sat under it in the shadow, so it did give shadow all by itself. But then it says in verse 6, and Jehovah God prepared a gourd and made it to come up over Jonah, that it might be a shadow over his head to deliver him from his grief. And that word grief is the same word evil back in Jonah 3:10 and also in Jonah 4 verse 1, that it might deliver him from his grief. So Jonah was exceeding glad of the gourd. And it's a hot day, you have some shadow with the booth, it's just even better, right? If a plant, and that's what the gourd would have to be, the word gourd is only found, I think, four or five times here in Jonah 4 and nowhere else. And so we don't get any help with the Bible, you know, how we define words by comparing scripture with scripture. We have to look within the chapter concerning this word, but it would have had to have been a plant, because God prepared a gourd, and it came up in a night, and then it withered. And even the word withered, when we check that out, that has to do with plants. So the gourd was a plant, and it would have been probably fairly large in order to cast enough shadow to give him any kind of relief. And so here's Jonah. He first builds the booth. And how do you build a booth? What do you have to find? Branches. You have to find branches according to the direction given in Leviticus, branches of various trees. So he finds a good number of branches, he puts it together, he's sitting under it in some shadow, the fire raises up overnight, and it's much more comfortable. Okay, so we know